Welcome to a lesson on conditional probability. Again, before we start, remember the probability of an event is equal to the favorable number of outcomes compared to the total number of outcomes, which can be expressed as a fraction, decimal, or percentage. Conditional probability is the probability of an event E2 occurring given that event E1 has already occurred. And this is how we denote the situation. The probability of E sub 2 given E sub 1 is equal to the probability of E sub 2 and E sub 1 divided by the probability of E sub 1. Now there's one thing to keep in mind here. It's great to have all these formulas to help us out, but if we can make sense of the situation, then we don't have to rely on these formulas and we can actually understand exactly what's happening. So for this first problem, we'll take a look at it using two different methods. One, just the basic probability formula, and two, using the conditional probability formula. And here's the problem. So if you roll one six-sided die, what is the probability of a 3 given you know the number is odd? So the probability of a 3 given we know that it's odd. Well, if we think about it logically, if we know that the number is already odd, that reduces the total number of outcomes. There are 3 numbers from 1 to 6 that are odd, 1, 3, and 5. So there's 3 possible outcomes given that we know that it's odd, and there's only one odd number that is 3, so the probability would be 1/3. Now if we take a look at the conditional probability formula, of course we should get the same answer, but it's going to look a little bit different. Let's see if we can apply this and get the same answer. So this would be equal to the probability of rolling a 3 and an odd divided by the probability of rolling an odd. Well, the probability of rolling a 3 and an odd, there's only one number that's a 3 and odd, so that would be 1/6 divided by the probability of rolling an odd would be 3/6. Well, 1/6 divided by 3/6 is the same as 1/6 times 6/3, and as you can see, the result is the same. We have 1/3. Now you may be asking, why would you want to use this formula anyway, because it seems a lot more complicated. But in some cases it will be appropriate, as we see in the next problem. At P-Town High School, the probability that a student takes computer programming and Spanish is 0.15. The probability that a student takes computer programming is 0.4. And here's the question. What is the probability that a student takes Spanish given that the student is taking computer programming? So we want to know what the probability is that a student will take Spanish given that we already know they're taking computer programming. This will equal the probability of a student taking Spanish and computer programming divided by the probability of a student taking computer programming. Again, remember that E sub 1 is the event that already occurred. Based upon this question, we already know they're taking computer programming. So we see computer programming here and also in the denominator. So the probability of a student taking Spanish and computer programming is 0.15, and the probability of a student taking computer programming is 0.4. We can go ahead and divide this, but it's equal to 0.375, which could be expressed as 37.5%. And again, what this tells us is if we know a student is already taking computer programming, they have a 37.5% chance they would be in Spanish as well. Let's go and take a look at another one. Here's a survey completed by adults with children. And they either had children in college or not in college, and they were asked whether they thought college was either too expensive, affordable, or too cheap. And here's the question. What is the probability that a person thinks college is too expensive given that they have a child in college? So we're only concerned about if the person was in this row, what's the probability that they would think that college was too expensive? So looking at our formula here, it's going to equal the probability that adult parents think that college is too expensive and they have a child in college, which is right here as 55%. And I'll write that in decimal form as 0.55. Divided by the probability of event 1, which is that they have a child in college. So the probability they have a child in college would be this entire row, which should be 55% plus 4% or 59% or 0.59. So if we take a look at this logically, if we're only considering the parents with a child in college, that would be this 59% as we see here. And then of the 59%, this is the portion that thought college was too expensive. So let's go ahead and divide this out. 0.55 divided by 0.59. So it comes out to about 0.932. Or if we want, 93.2%. Hopefully that makes sense, because of the people that have children in college, we can see that most of them thought it was too expensive compared to a very small percentage that thought it was affordable. Let's take a look at a couple others. These two, I think, is going to make it very clear that if we can make sense of the problems, we do not want to just memorize or rely on some special formula for a conditional probability. Here we have a standard deck of cards. Two cards are drawn without replacement in succession. What is the probability that the second card drawn is an ace, given that the first card was an ace? Again, just thinking of probability as the comparison of favorable outcomes to total outcomes, if we know the first card is an ace, that leaves a total of 51 cards. And we also know that the first card is an ace, and there are a total of 4 aces in the deck. So if the first card is an ace, that only leaves 3 aces left in the deck, and therefore the probability of drawing an ace given the first card is an ace would be 3 over 51. And this is the probability that we're looking for, and that's all there is to this question. So even though it's conditional probability, if we can make sense of it, it can be very straightforward. For number 2, 2 cards are drawn without replacement. What is the probability that the second card is a red face card, given that the first card is a red face card? Again, there are 12 face cards in a deck of 52 cards. So if we know the first card is already a face card, then there's only 51 cards left in the deck. And if one of the 12 face cards has already been drawn, that leaves 11 favorable outcomes, and therefore the probability would be 11 over 51. So even though there is a special formula here that can be used for a conditional probability, if we can make sense of the situation, we may not actually have to use it. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.